Listen to that sizzle.
Oh my god, it sounds so good. Well, we are Tony and Peggy from Stressless Camping.
We are two RV industry veterans who travel part-time in a small trailer.
Looking to share big adventures and help you.
With great tips.
Tricks.
And discounts.
And here's a tip. We got a FireDisc Cooker from FireDiscCookers.com. And they sent the FireDisc to us so that we could share it with you and see what we thought of it. And, well,
We thought it was terrific for making bacon.
Cooking, among other things.
Cooking bacon.
So this is our FireDisc Cooker. And what it is it's sort of a wok that sits on a tall shelf. We're showing you the underneath there was the wind sensor or the wind protector for the flame. Okay. So there's basically a big flame in the middle, driven by either one of those little green 1 pound propane bottle, or they have an adapter where you can get a 5 pound, you know, your typical barbecue bottle.
Right.
And so on the bottle, there's the adjuster. So you go from high to low. And
of course, the first thing we did was season it with bacon because that's what you do. It seasons very much like cast iron.
Yeah, absolutely. So here I am showing you the different temperatures. Since there's basically a big flame in the middle, what happens is obviously the middle is where the business end of the cooking gets done. And then you can use the various outer areas for different things. We used it to keep food warm. We made tortillas. We melted cheese on tortillas on the outer area. For example, here we are. We cooked up a bunch of bacon. And there was a pool of bacon grease, so I fried some German bratwurst in the pool of bacon
grease. Because what's better than bratwurst? Bratwurst fried in bacon.
Indeed. But those bacon strips on the outer ring, they stayed nice and warm. So it worked out pretty well, and it got them a little bit crispy, too, which was good. It was
my favorite.
Yeah, we fed a lot of people bacon that
day. Yeah, we did.
another option is the lid. And you can actually steam in this thing. You could put water in the FireDisc Cooker. So it's kind of cool. So here's the unboxing of the FireDisc Cooker. People really seem to like those. And so
it was really easy to unbox. It's basically three parts. That really heavy. That was the hardest part was was that it was heavy. But you can see that it's well packed. It's got protection paper and plastic and stuff. And so it's just a matter of getting that pan out, which, like I said, it was kind of heavy. It took me a second. And then
well, one of the things that impressed me about this is there's nothing flimsy or cheap about it.
Absolutely. I mean, not. Yeah,
it's heavy.
It is a big honking hunk of steel.
Yeah. I mean, as you can see, it's like a giant wok, for lack of a, and the idea, I guess, came from tractor discs.
I guess people for a long time have been using tractor discs to cook on. They weld a little bit in the middle and close it off. That is the gas adapter. And then you'll see me try to pull the flame out, but it's actually attached to the legs.
So yeah.
So it didn't work out.
And there are also shorter versions. And this is the 3 foot tall. And that's sort of like a table height type of deal.
Right. So like stovetop height. And then there's a 2 foot that's more like a fire pit height if you're used to... If you're used to cooking over a fire pit and you like the lower height.
So there's the burner.
And look at those good rubber tips on the tops and the bottoms.
Yeah, I think that might be silicone, but whatever it is, it's a good rubber tip. And again, once you get these X's, those two leg sections put together, the FireDisc just sits by gravity on top, but based on its mass, it's got a lot of gravity and it doesn't feel wiggly or anything like that. I was rather impressed with that. And there you go.
Boom, the legs are together. That's all it takes. Just sliding one piece into the other and then putting that pan on top, and it's like I said, it's heavy enough that it sits there. So we got some accessories too in addition to the lid. Look at the size of this cooking weapon. I mean, holy moly, that thing is big and strong.
And that's what they call it, a cooking weapon. Yeah. it's a pretty appropriate term. And then there's the
wind guard that keeps the flame from getting blown out.
So that's that. I would say if you're going to get one of these, that would be a must. And so that windscreen, I think it makes a big difference because we had friends there with Blackstones and the wind at the camp out just kept blowing them out.
Blowing out the Blackstone fire.
They were swearing and I was cooking.
When you order your fire disc, get that windscreen.
Absolutely.
And that big old giant cooking tool. Man, oh, yeah. Wow.
The cooking weapon without a doubt. So what do you think? What would you tell people about the fire disc cooker?
I would tell people that make sure your arms are strong because it's going to be heavy, but it's great. It's got all those cooking zones and it's really strong and it'll last forever. And we actually have it set up in the backyard now because we came home just like we do with our coffee. Yeah. AeroPress. We can't stop using it once we come home from a trip. So with our AeroPress coffee and our Fire Disc, we can pretend like we're camping every day.
Yeah. Well, and we're going to next week.
That's right.
In the meantime, yeah, would I recommend the Fire Disc? I would. It's it's about $500. It's the invention of two guys in Texas who went to school and they decided this is a great idea.
Yeah.
And it is. And like I say, it's very substantial. It is not cheaply made. They have really thought through all the details. I would say it's a quality product. And I'd give it two thumbs up.
Wait, I have coffee. Two thumbs up.
So there you go. That's our take on the Fire Disc Cooker. And go check it out. They've got a great Facebook group where they share recipes and all of that. So far, we have obviously cooked a tremendous amount of bacon. Because why wouldn't you? Oh, right. That cooking weapon has a hook. All of their tools have a hook. So they hook on the side of the fire disc. That hook is also a bottle opener.
Yep.
So there you go. Points for me. So far, we've cooked a lot of bacon. We've cooked different meats in it. In addition, I also steamed some Brussels sprouts
because vegetable. Why not?
But it worked out really well. And the more you get to, the more times you use the Fire Disc, the more you get used to how it cooks. But I really like that you stand there and cook and it's just not wiggly or wobbly or anything like that. And so there you go. That's our take on the Fire Disc. What do you think? Have you tried one out? What do you think of it? We'd like
to know. Send us your bacon sizzle videos.
Yeah, yeah. Sell the sizzle. All right, well, thank you so much for joining us here again. And we hope you enjoy some fantastic
happy camping!